Silas is slowly rising.
Yeah, the kind of draft win that we saw as a safeguard to get him completely to safety. Toosin's going to land a hook onto Gorilla here, though, and there's the teleport on Fleek trying to come forward. There's no kicks out as Kuro, ooh, in turret range, will be able to grab themselves the first blood. This is so valuable for KT. Going to be going begging, so on. Looking for some extra damage here onto Summit. And Call of the Forge God will be coming out here. See whether that helps even out this particular trade as Summit not going to get stunned up a second time. On Fleet going to turn up, though. This should be able to get themselves a flash. That's good positioning on the pillar. We'll guarantee that one.
So the flash came out of Fate.
Yeah, right.
So maybe he was predicting the flash and he's like, well, I'm not going to flash myself. Let me just get the flash.
Maybe not wanting to trade flashes without having the necessarily needing to, as Root's going to get devoured eventually. The box comes in. Root escapes from it, but unfortunately for Gorilla, he's not going to be able to. That is two kills.
Now, as there is a lot of pressure by the side of KT that is being exerted onto this bottom lane. Aiming just going to be given all of the money. Doosan isn't even sticking around.
That's a teleport. Aiming should be able to grab this. As now Fate, after teleporting in, is looking to see what he can get done. Toosin, very, very low as Aiming. Moonlight Vigil comes down. Fate, it's a one-for-one trade, but make that a one-for-two as Sandbox do answer. So double teleports invested. They lose the turret.
We'll see how he'll be able to use it. I mean, he's trying to move towards his second item for now, but definitely stacking up the gold with the most here in this game.
Oh, hook gonna come in. That's a great box. Kick back, and that's a very easy kill onto the Trundle. Call of the Forge God does basically nothing to get him out without taking any damage. The cannon going to be able to wrap around, look for a flank, and Sandbox want nothing of it. KT will be able to lock down the first Mountain Drake of the game. Toosin still able to scout forward, Aiming not going to be offering his damage here as Sohan got himself back towards the turret. Call of the Forge God coming through from the Silas as Gorilla going to save on Fleek for now, but Sohan flashing into the back line, not quite the connections that they were looking for, as that was a decent shockwave, but not enough to actually secure any kills. And Kuro able to abscond his way out of there. Looks like outer turret will be claimed here, though, as Shockwave pulls back only Toosin. Hook is going to connect onto his opposite number there, and he has to go golden. Good double knockup, but Aiming not exactly going to take too much damage. Now Kuro looks for the backline. Shockwave onto one, as there goes the cannon. And look at all of the years coming out of Aiming. He's not exactly the main one in this fight, but he's still able to tidy up. Summit, I mean, he's pretty tanky, but it does not matter. As yes, they managed to take down Toosin, but the rest of the team gets obliterated. Aiming even able to find the Gravitum, and now Root's going to be dead. That's the ace.
And so it doesn't look like KT are going to have an easy time just straight up pushing it.
Whoa, shot
nice,
wave.
Nice damage, Fate.
Yeah,
wow.
It. Yeah, it got the Mountain Drake shield as Aiming. Ooh, he's been walking slightly to the right from abilities. It's been working quite nicely as Moonlight Vigil comes down. Denies if... Oh, okay, never mind. Not denying. The damage does half the health bar of Root there, as he will be able to tag them.
Cannon and Silas at the same time.
Yeah.
They're so far ahead in this game.
It's absolutely crazy. I mean, at least Fate and Summit are very close to that, as the hook is going to land there. Toosin decides to go in, as Bono is going to tag up Root. Immediate exhaust will deny a lot of that damage, as Root's trying to kite this one out. Kuro goes golden. Moonlight Vigil does basically nothing as Summit buys so much time as Toosin finds Fate. He is going to go down, but Aiming's going to show him how many years it's going to take them. There's the slicing Maelstrom, but look at Gorilla. He tried just so hard to take care of his AD carry. And in the meantime, Aiming's just going to shoot Summit to death. USS is complete, but Flash on cooldown now. And Aiming, yeah, I mean, I think he took some damage there, but eventually with his double lifesteal, it's going to go back up to full. And now we're going to see whether KT can just win the game.
Yeah, they're going to try for it here. They don't have any Baron, though, and their minions are pretty low, so they're just going to get smited out.
Yeah, well, Summit going to take a lot of damage here. Onfleek dies as an afterthought as Aiming. He's going to get to work on these turrets now. Only one Nexus turret remaining here as KT look for the 2-0. As Summit, yeah, he's going to get pile driven. And 8-1-4, Aiming, I think he's looking at back-to-back pogs here. Fantastic performance out of the KT AD carry, and this bounce back.
Rolls to right in their face. And that was, again, a lot of damage. Aiming had some pretty sick stats before today's games.